Dry steam power plants extract steam directly from the Earth's depths, utilizing it to spin turbines for electricity generation. These plants are relatively rare due to the limited availability of locations producing dry steam. The first dry steam plant was constructed in Tuscany, Italy in 1904. Among the three types of geothermal power plants, dry steam requires the highest temperature to convert water to steam and drive turbines. Despite this, it uses minimal liquid water, hence the term dry steam. This is how dry steam power plants work. The process begins with drilling wells deep into the earth to access the steam. Once brought to the surface, the high-pressure steam drives turbines connected to generators, producing electricity. The condensed steam is then cooled and recycled back into the earth, completing the cycle. Despite requiring the highest temperature among geothermal plant types, dry steam plants operate efficiently with minimal water usage. Binary cycle power plants are typically located in regions where water temperatures rising from the surface are lower compared to flash steam geothermal power plants. They function by utilizing pentane or isobutane as secondary fluids known for their low boiling temperatures. These secondary fluids are heated using surface water, resulting in the production of steam. The resulting steam is then used to drive turbines generating electricity. Binary cycle power plants operate by pumping hot water from underground reservoirs to the surface through production wells. This hot water heats a secondary fluid with a lower boiling point, such as pentane or isobutane, in a heat exchanger. When this secondary fluid boils and turns into vapor, it powers turbines that are linked to generators, which produce electricity. Afterwards, the secondary fluid is condensed back into liquid form by passing it through a cooling system with water and then used again in the process. At the same time, the hot water from the underground reservoir is sent back underground, ensuring that the cycle can continue producing electricity constantly and using geothermal energy efficiently.